All right, coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight showdown. Well, there is no denying this man's striking credentials. Prevailing wisdom is he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
He has to. You know, this is what got him to the show. It was being able to use the hands to set up the kicks. We all talk about the high-level boxing background of this young man. But as he's developed great knees.
Yeah.
He's developed great timing, great counter skills, and also the beautiful right high kick. The right high kick is something he hides very well as he follows with a jab, right hand, left hook. High kick comes over the top, and he can put you to sleep.
No doubt about it. He will try to put on a striking clinic once again here tonight. All right, so here he is representing the American Kickboxing Academy, the inimitable Khabib Nurmagomedov. And this guy makes his way to the Octagon, D.C. You run out of time setting up everything he's accomplished, but he always puts that status as an undefeated fighter and UFC champion on the line. He will do so again here tonight.
The moment he walked in the AKA, you understood that there was something special about Nurmagomedov. He was a guy that was always listening. Although he spoke no English, he was always listening and paying attention to try to learn and how to improve himself. And the moment he stepped foot in the gym, he was just open to each and every lesson, and now it's showing over the course of his UFC career. He was undefeated going into the UFC, and he has only built on that and become a champion, one of the most well-rounded fighters in all of the UFC.
You know, your college wrestling teammates have told me when you showed up at Oklahoma State, you didn't speak English either.
No, I didn't. It was all Southern Creole accent. It was all, hey, my boy.
Right. Well, your English is now very proper, and so is Khabib's, and he's back on the proven ground here tonight, again trying to prove himself as one of the pound-for-pound greatest fighters on this UFC roster.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! Five rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet, 2 inches tall, weighing in at 122 pounds. Fighting out of Paris, France, the great! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a grappler, holding a professional record of 29 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet, 10 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of the Republic of Dagestan, Russia, Khabib the Eagle Nurmagomedov!
All right, commit to the rules of the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out.
So here we go, this highly anticipated fight is now underway. Looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler. Am I simplifying things too much?
In this instance, you aren't, because this is what got these two men to the show.
Right.
One guy is known for his diverse attack on the feet. The other guy is known for his ability to drag the fight to the mat and put his opponents in danger from the very start of the grappling exchanges.
Oh, made good use of his size there as he lands the flush knee.
Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Well, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Lands with the kick there. No pad on that foot.
No shin guard. He's taking all of that kick every time he throws.
timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very active.
And they separate.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
So 1 minute into this fight, and as many people expected, the action absolutely crazy, back and forth. This is a full-on brawl, DC.
It's hard to watch a fight like this and call a fight like this because you never know when somebody's gonna take that one shot that finishes the fight.
Got the single collar tie.
Nice strike.
Yet again, they will clinch here. And those knees aren't just for... Oh, goes to the ankle pick now to get him down, DC. We'll see how he chooses to proceed from here.
Got the ankle kick. Let's see how he advances from this position.
Just over 3 minutes to go. Oh, wicked nice leg kick there, DC.
Can't take too many of those.
Nurmagomedov gets caught with that punch.
Really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks. Caught that kick there.
Oh, caught him there with the head kick. All right, single collar tie now. So as we pull up some numbers here for you, 29 total strikes have now landed for Khabib Nurmagomedov. Just a slip there. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. That kick blocked by Nurmagomedov.
Great timing on that double leg.
All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the grounded pound will be a plenty for this position. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, that's a nice strike there by Nurmagomedov.
Yeah, Khabib Nurmagomedov is not only a wrestler, he's a full-on mixed martial artist now, and it showed in that exchange.
The right hand just misses.
Look at how he turned his hip into that leg kick.
Oh, single collar tie here.
Oh, he did a great job of rotating him into an underhook.
And once again, looking for that highlight reel KO with that front kick. Gets inside here and lands the elbow.
Ooh, big shot lands.
Oh, a little single collar tie there. Oh, a nice inside leg kick landed there by Nurmagomedov. And that one certainly found the target.
Ooh, head kick lands, he's hurt.
Just unable to quite find that range. One minute to go here in the opening round. And they separate.
Nice head kick.
Oh, looking to land the leg kick. That one checked. Pinpoint accuracy on that kick.
No wind-up, no tell, just a brutal kick.
Single collar tie now.
Nice super punch.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. All right, 20 seconds to go in the round. Well, you saw us reference it in the tail of the tape, DC. He's got the reach advantage and certainly made good use of it there in landing that jab. Oh, man, this guy kicks like a mule.
So hard. He kicks so hard every time you see him drive his shin into his opponent.
That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, there's the horn. The round is over, but not before he was cut on his nose from the strikes in that round. Back to the stool. Cut man is in. Should be able to shut that cut and prevent it from becoming an issue moving forward. But, of course, as soon as he gets struck in that next round, it could open back up. All right, DC, let's look at some of the highlights from the last round. Lot for the replay guys to choose from.
Yeah, man, these guys stood on a quarter in the middle of the octagon. Take one to give one. Over and over, each guy landed, and they both landed very well over the course of that first round. That was good, man. Nice strike. Nice, sneaky head kick.
Oh, another. Another strike to the body. Not a lot of real estate there, but he found it. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Try to establish that jab.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick. You're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head. Big punch land. Ooh.
Connects now with the 1-2. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here.
Big head kick.
Some nice power there with the left hook upstairs. Head kick partially blocked. All right, he closes the distance. He gets the single collar tie.
Yeah, he's mixing it all up. Beautiful takedown to play.
Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, got to be careful playing around inside his guard.
Absolutely, John. That's why you don't sit in a full guard. When you sit in a full guard, it gives these guys too many opportunities to chase submissions. And now he's jumping around trying.
Moves inside and is able to land the flying knee. And I guess, DC, only in your dreams do you have this type of height and length. He certainly made good use of it there. Well, that left hand has been there at times, not on that attempt. Oh, collar tie. Looked like it did stun him a little bit.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. He's got to go chase that finish down now. That's how you finish your fight.
Man! Oh, picks him up to
his
feet.
He's got him up.
Being able to pick up another man and say, you go here, bro, you go here.
I can't. I've done it before. John, I've done it before.
Push him on. Oh, his opponent's squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Outstanding knee to the body there. He's the taller fighter. Might as well put that size to good use, and he certainly did so there. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active.
What a tricky head kick.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Nurmagomedov gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these.
Oh, that will not take him down. Cut him. Take him down. Cut him. Over and over. He secured these takedowns.
All right, north-south position now. We'll see who transitions first. Well, he's in a compromising spot here, DC. You got to figure out a way to get back to your feet. A lot of top pressure being applied here.
Oh, right in the mouth.
Oh, looks like he's transitioning an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. And attack an armbar.
Continuing to try to manipulate the head here.
Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Oh, and that was a violent tap there, so he submits him with the arm bar.
I mean, just steps ahead of the competition where you're playing checkers, he's playing chess in the ground fighting, and it showed tonight in this big submission victory. Goodness, what a fight.
Yeah, that is some high-level Brazilian jiu-jitsu right there. Just the way he transitioned to secure the arm up against his body and ultimately forced the tap. High high-level stuff out of that young man here tonight. All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He was able to get the fight to the ground exactly where he wanted it. Eventually, his opponent gave him an opportunity to get a submission. He did that, and he should be very proud of the work he did tonight in the octagon.
So there he is, your winner by submission. That is a finish they will likely be talking about for some time. Big win, major statement made to the rest of this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 45 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by tap out due to an arm bar, Khabib the Eagle Nurmagomedov.
Well, what an incredible result here tonight as you see the winner there celebrating his victory by way of submission. And they put so much stock into finishing this fight. They felt like to really spin his career forward, they needed to not just win but get the finish, and they certainly got it tonight.
They got the finish. He's such a terrific grappler. Every time he is on his back, he looks for submissions over and over again. Eventually, he found one tonight and got the desired result.